Coming up on this edition of MHS Rewind, we'll take a look at our new senior class officers and how MHS is helping out our students during the holiday season.
And in sports, we'll take a look at the wrestlers and their victory over Monrovia and the swim team at Mooresville. Good morning, MHS. I'm Sydney Zala.
And I'm Carissa Wampler. We'll have all that and more coming up on this edition of MHS Rewind. The senior class election was held last Friday, and as Hannah Odell tells us, the process was done a little bit differently this year.
This year's election was almost identical to the elections held in previous years. The senior class gathered in the auditorium, listened to the presidential candidates' speeches, and last Friday took to the polls to elect the senior class president, vice president, treasurer, and secretary. The difference? The voting was done online through Google Forms as opposed to previous years where the students would vote on voting machines. The downside to the way the elections were held before this year was that many students who were involved in internships or attended Hammonds, Hoosier Hills, or night school were unable to vote since they were not in school.
This year we have about 35 seniors on internship, 17 in night school and at Hammonds, and when you add in the Hoosier Hills kids, about 20%, over 60 seniors, could vote. That didn't seem right.
Joseph DeRosset had the most votes and took the title of senior class president.
I ran for senior class president because I've always wanted to lead my class. I've always wanted to represent all my fellow seniors.
Alongside DeRosset, Kyle Smith won vice president, Allie Roy was elected treasurer, and Haley Taylor won secretary. For MHS Rewinds, I'm Hannah Odell.
Mooresville High School held their annual holiday choral concert on December 14th. Ethan Kidwell was there to capture the performance.
Martinsville was in for a sweet surprise at the annual cookie stroll. Claudia Willis has more on the story.
Smiles, friend making, and of course cookies were a common sight at the annual cookie stroll in downtown Martinsville on Saturday, December 10th. The cookie stroll is a chance for people in the community to check out local businesses and mingle with others from the community.
Just a good business day, introduces the businesses. If you haven't been in, just get you acquainted with them.
Passports were sold to the participants of the cookie stroll, which allowed them to get a stamp from each cookie stop they visited and get a cookie. The cookie stroll is organized by the Rediscover Martinsville group.
I have a committee of 5 people who organize the whole cookie stroll, but there are two co-directors and I am one of them.
The cookie stroll is a bit challenging to organize, but organizers feel there really is a lot of good that comes out of it.
It's always really a lot of work, but I like that because people just sort of come out of the woodwork to volunteer. So this year people were contacting me because they wanted to bake cookies.
Everyone involved, whether it was an organizer, stroller, or vendor, enjoyed themselves and the effect that the cookie stroll has on the community.
I just think it's a great part of the holiday season with Martinsville, and it creates an atmosphere of giving.
This year had the biggest turnout ever, and organizers hope that next year will have an even bigger turnout. For MHS Rewind, I'm Claudia Willis.
Students at MHS are getting involved with the Angel Tree this year. Noah Thacker has the story.
Spreading some Christmas cheer. That's what some sophomores in Mrs. Klodfelter's English class are trying to do once again this year by helping out with the Angel Tree.
I think I've had a lot of kids who want to get involved. Two different classes have adopted 3 kids this year, which is more than I've ever had. And I just really think that's a cool thing, that kids want to get involved with their friends.
The Angel Tree has been going on for several years now and is a coordinated effort between the bookstore, guidance, and student council to get students who are in need presents for Christmas.
This is the first time I've ever participated, and it's neat to me to see that, hey, all of these kids are going to help this one kid who we don't even know.
Klodfelter selected the ornaments off the Angel Tree, and the class worked together to get some of the items the anonymous student had listed on the back.
One of my goals is just to have my kids learn that Christmas is about giving, and a lot of times it's with your own peers. They don't have things you do, and it's just kind of a learning experience for them, and I really like that.
They spent Friday wrapping the presents and then sent them down to the front office. For MHS Rewind, I'm Noah Thacker.
On December 10th, the MHS Robotics Club competed at their first competition. Claire Piney has more on the story.
The MHS Robotics Club put their robots to the test, competing in 2 courses. The robotics team first competed in the full pull course. The team had to create a robot that could pull weights across a synthetic turf.
Whoever can't make the full distance is out, and we just go until there's one left.
The team won 3rd place in the full pull competition. The second course was called the recovery course.
Well, it was basically a white tabletop type surface with a black line down it. And the line has zigzags and curves, and the robot has to follow that line to reach the target area, where it has to pick up a toxic containment unit. It has to pick that up and place it on a platform.
For the recovery course, contestants were able to use a practice course to prepare. The teams also had to fix complications with their robots during the competition.
We didn't plan out the actual frame of the robot enough, and it's been difficult to change any of the workings of it.
Overall, Mr. Heacock thinks the teams did well.
I had 3 teams. One team didn't make it. Another team, we got into the finals, but we just got eliminated. And then my other team got 3rd place and will actually get a trophy today, so that's pretty good.
Even with complications, the robotics team still loves what they are doing.
Occasionally, things go wrong, and that's never fun. But whenever you get it working, it's just the biggest sense of accomplishment in the world.
For MHS Rewind, I'm Claire Piney.
Now let's turn our attention to winter sports here at MHS. The Artesian Wrestlers hosted the Monrovia Bulldogs last week at the John R. Wooden Gym.
Martinsville Wrestling had an exciting win over Monrovia last Thursday. Assistant coach Briar Runyon says the boys did fantastic.
A couple hard-fought matches. Keaton Fisher got the win to win the dual meet for us. Clayton Scroggs got up to do real well. My brother got a good pin over a good wrestler.
Ethan Runyon was proud of his match, but sees room for improvement.
I think I did pretty well in my match overall. I think could have been more offensive, but all in all, felt like I gave a pretty good amount of heart.
Clayton Scroggs is undefeated and ranked 4th in the state. The senior won against the state's 11th ranked wrestler, Garrison Lee, in a close match, 3-2.
It was a tough match, but it shouldn't have been that close. I should have beat him by more.
But Scroggs says he was happy with how his teammates wrestled.
Keaton wrestled really good. He wrestled state qualifier Bryson Denny, and Keaton handled him that match, and we kind of handled Monrovia, so I thought we wrestled really well.
Freshman Jared Drake pinned his opponent at 126 pounds. Luke Bradley won a 4-2 at 132 pounds. Dexter Grubb won 10-4 at 138 pounds. At 145 pounds, Cody Drake dominated his opponent 17-0. And Hunter James pinned his opponent at 152 pounds. The boys took home the win over the Bulldogs 35-30. They'll be back on the mat December 27th for the Holiday Classic in Mooresville.
The boys and girls swim team traveled to Mooresville for a mid-state conference meet last Tuesday. Mackenzie Meyer has the story.
Riley May got the girls off to a fast start with a win in the second race of the night, the 200 freestyle. The senior also touched the wall first in the 500 freestyle to help lead the Artesians to the win over the Pioneers.
Tonight, I think I swam pretty well, given that the past two meets I haven't been doing so well. I'm not at the time that I was at, let's say, a year ago, but I have been dropping time by every meet, so it's getting better.
May also helped lead the 200 and 400 relay teams to victory. The Artesians also had a couple of other strong swims. Liz Colliver won the 100 fly, and Madeline Miller placed first in the 100 back. While the girls' team was led by upperclassmen, the boys' team was led by a freshman. Coach Robert Hayslip is very happy with Miles Anderson and how his times are dropping. On Tuesday, Anderson won the 50 freestyle.
I did all right, but I knew and felt that I should have done better.
Anderson also helped the 400 relay team finish first, but the boys dropped the meet to the Pioneers.
We had a lot of mental mistakes in terms of like missing assignments where they needed to be. A couple things with turns that I wasn't really happy about, but overall they swam hard tonight, so we're getting better. We're getting better.
The boys and girls swim team will be back in the MHS pool December 31st to compete against the Decatur Central Hawks. For MHS Rewind, I'm Mackenzie Meyer.
The girls' basketball team traveled to Plainfield on Friday night to battle the 12th-ranked Quakers. The Artesians jumped out to an early lead over the Quakers in the mid-state conference matchup and then held on to get the 51-49 win. Kayana Traylor led Martinsville with 17 points. Jessica Nix added 16, and Meredith Deckard finished with 8. The girls will be back in action Thursday at Franklin Central.
The boys' basketball team picked up a big win on Saturday night at the John R. Woodham Gymnasium over Eastern Green. Martinsville got off to a quick start and led throughout the game en route to their 81-66 victory over the Thunderbirds. Levi Chandler led the Artesians with a game-high 23 points. Jonathan Collier threw in 17. Luke Beaver had 9. And Tyler Stead finished with 8 points, 13 rebounds, and 7 assists. The boys will be back on the hardwood for the Wooden Classic on December 30th.
The Mid-State has released a list of all conference athletes for the fall sports. Ethan Kidwell has a closer look.
For girls golf, Martinsville had 4 all-conference athletes. Senior Sloan Winders led the way for the Arties. Martinsville also had 3 sophomores, Emily Bennett, Aaron Bennett, and Emma Keller. In tennis, junior Hunter Sylvester was all-conference at number 1 singles. Marino Dolph and Kyle Smith were both all-conference runners in cross-country. Martinsville had 3 all-conference soccer players, Caleb Urban and Andrew Marion for the boys, and Julia Ritchie for the girls. There were 2 all-conference volleyball players, Madison Martin and Ashlyn Van Landingham. And to round off the list, the lone all-conference football player was Colton Tribby. For MHS Rewind, I'm Ethan Kidwell.
That does it for this edition of MHS Rewind. For Sydney Zola and the rest of the fourth period Rewind class, I'm Carissa Wampler.
Have a great holiday break.